Hi there, Simon from SimonWoods.com. I don't know if you've noticed, I've been doing single wine videos for the last few weeks, months. Well, it depends when I get this up posted. But I was developing a backlog, so I've got a roster of six Chardonnays here that I'm going to dig into. How many different countries? We've got France, Chile, France, South Africa, USA. So four countries. Four countries, three French wines, and let's dig in. First one is a Chablis Blason de Bourgogne, La Réserve, 2012. Let's give this one a whirl. Well, it smells like Chablis. It's got that mixture of the edge of citrus, citrus finesse, with something that feels like it's going to be richer and creamier. And it's a nice tension that when Chablis gets it right, there's no other wine like it in the world. And it smells, I don't know how much this is. I can't imagine it's probably hovering around between 10 and 12 and then might be discounted every now and then, but it smells pretty good at that price. Yeah, a bit of tension, the crispness, and light, dainty on its feet, and that strange thing where there's a rich flavour but a taut, lean, svelte finish. There are classier Chablis, but that does what it's supposed to, and it does it reasonably well. Let's try an unoaked Chardonnay from another part of the world. This is the Kalfu Kuda Chardonnay unoaked from the Leyda Valley in Chile, 2013. And this is made by, I think it's the Ventisquero organisation. Let's give it a whirl. You missed the bit where I poured it into the remnants of the Chablis, so I had to start again. But I stick my nose in here and it's got that slightly grapefruit, juicy cashew, bit of pineapple, it's funny when I think of unoaked Chardonnays in places where warmish places, although Leyda's not exactly warm, sometimes the oak, you almost like miss the oak, but here I smell it and it feels like it's quite a confident wine in its un-oakiness. Let's taste it. Like a vibrant nectarine. And with this grapefruit and lemon tension. There's this little bit of cashew character going on in there. And there's also, it feels like they've made it in what's called a reductive environment. So it's getting these ever so slightly Sauvignon-like cabbage edge, if that makes sense. But and it's a style of wine. Some people love it, some people don't like it. I quite like it, I think, and I think here it works really well. It also feels like a wine that it's 6 months older than, six months younger than the Chablis, and feels like a wine that's got quite a few a bit of legs, and it feels like it's gonna go on and improve in bottle for I don't know how long, because I think this is the first time they've done it, but it looks pretty good. Make sure I empty my glass this time. Wine number three, we are in the south of France for the next two. So this is Montsablé Vin Sud Authentique, authentic wine of the south, Chardonnay Pédoc, and vintage 2013. Let's give it a whirl. It smells safe. It smells like if you wanted to do a slightly... I don't know what the price is, slightly upmarket, well it's 10 quid. A slightly upmarket southern French Chardonnay, not top of the tree, hopefully we've got that coming up in the next one. So you'd give it a little bit of oak treatment, you'd give it a little bit of lees stirring, but it doesn't feel like there's any real personality. It feels almost like someone's slightly bolted it together. Sounds a bit pejorative. I better taste it, don't I? Bit of mandarin orange. Yeah, mandarin orange, that's quite strong. Cashew. Again, there's this slight creamy, leesy character that's gone into that, where the lees react with the wine and produces this slightly creamy, nutty character that sometimes reminds me of halva. Can't remember the last time I had halva. I'm not a big fan of it, but you're getting almost that slight, not cloying character, but that style. But the mandarin bit keeps it fresh. But it feels safe. It feels simple. It's okay. It's no sparks. One of those wines that you'd happily finish the first glass. And maybe look for something else for the second glass. Let's see whether we can improve on that with still in the Languedoc with Abbotts and Delaunay Limoux Chardonnay 2012 Zephyr. Don't know whether Zephyr's the vineyard or just the name of the cuvée that they give it. Let's give it a whirl. Now it feels here like they've made something that's got more density in the fruit in the first place. Feels also like there's more of a citrus crispness and tension about it, and they've used higher quality oak. And yet, at the same time, I used that word safe on the previous one. There's still something here that is a little bit, just feels a little bit, smells like someone's been a little bit too controlling. It feels like it's going to be nice, but it may be a little bit too correct. Better taste it, doesn't it? And it's one of those wines that you can almost like go down the boxes and say, right, crisp fruit, yes. Nicely handled oak, not too much influence, but it makes its presence felt. Yes, nice élevage, so you're getting a gentle maturity of the flavours. Yes, but then you think, in terms of, it almost feels like someone who's just come out of college and hasn't learnt, and has got a really good degree, but hasn't developed its full personality. I don't know whether that's going to come with further time in the bottle, or whether it's a vineyard thing, and as the vineyard ages, then maybe there'll be more to come from it. But it feels, again, safe. Upmarket, but safe. I mean, it's certainly a pretty nice wine, safe. Let's see whether we are safe in the last two. First one is, can't read the label because it's all in white. Warwick Estate, white label, 2011 Chardonnay. Doesn't say Chardonnay on the front label, it says Chardonnay on the back label. And from Stellenbosch. Let's give it a whirl. Now this is funny. I would almost like the winemaker here to have been given the previous lot of fruit, because here it feels like there is a extra. It hasn't got the crispness of the previous one, but it's got a more open-hearted, generous character. There's a mealiness, and it's like an oatmeal character that is partly to do with the way in which it's been aged. But it also feels like there's a gentler, more relaxed hand on the tiller, and the creases on the jeans that are there when he's just come out of from doing his MBA on the previous one. Here, there's a bit more dirt in the creases, and maybe the creases have even gone. So it smells of a more confident wine, and it smells like it's going to be fuller, richer, and it's more on that peachy edge than maybe the citrus and green apple of the previous one. But yeah, it smells a bit more grown up. Grown-up's a funny one, but it feels like it's been made by someone who likes the more fun side of life than the slightly more serious previous one. Yeah, it's these pear, peach, the nectarine, citrus zip on the end, nuttiness, oatmeal, yeah, it's a year and a half older than the than the previous one. So maybe that the Abbotts is going to turn into the Warwick. But for the moment, the Warwick just looks a little bit more like the one you want to hang out with on a Sunday afternoon. I like that. Final wine is, we're in California, 2010, Marimar Estate, Don Miguel Chardonnay. And this is their, they do a number of bottlings. This is La Masia. I never know whether it's La Masia or La Masia. I'm going to say La Masia. But anyway, let's try it. It's strange, Dean, these three. The Warwick sits in the middle of them, both in terms of the order I'm doing my tasting, and also it feels like stylistically. The first one was on that lean, tense side. This one is really quite big, rich, buttery, it's got a little some of that oatmeal character that was in the in the Warwick, but almost feels a little bit too much. Anyway, I'll try it. Lots and lots of flavour, but lots and lots of rather loud flavour. There's this buttery, malolactic, mealy edge, and the fruit has gone that little bit too ripe. Well, let's have a look at alcohol. 14.5% compared with the Warwick, which is 14%, so not all that much difference there, and the Limoux one, which is 13%. So, yeah, as I suspected, the Warwick sits very stylistically between those two, and for me, at a higher point. I mean, the Marimar Torres one, it's okay, but it feels it's a style that I know a lot of people have grown out of. It's big and rich and full, and but you want to almost like turn it down and say, can you pick the fruit a bit earlier, whether it was a little bit crisper. It's okay, but the Warwick is the Warwick's best of those three. But I like the Chablis, and I like that that Kalfu Kuda. Don't know whether Kalfu is the name of the range or Kuda is the name of the range, and one's the winery. I don't know, but all I know is it looked pretty good today. See you soon.